The year was 2019. A young man by the name of Mr. Arroyo had dreams of becoming the world's greatest turkey gobbler. Unfortunately, he ran into a roadblock, and he was defeated at the 2019 Elkhorn Area Middle School Turkey Gobble Off Contest. This is his story.
All right, Mr. Arroyo, are you ready? I mean, that turkey has pneumonia or something. But no rules. No rules. Here we go.
After being humiliated that day out on the court and being called a baby turkey in front of hundreds of students, Mr. Arroyo was devastated. He felt lost. He felt as though he had no purpose. He felt as though all of his dreams were ripped away from him in that single moment. But did that stop him? No. He decided right then and there he was going to become the world's best turkey gobbler. So he found the best books. He began to practice and had one goal in mind: be the best. And he struggled. This is no easy task, but his dedication and his grit would get him to the point where he wanted to be, and that was the greatest turkey gobbler of all time. After months of practicing, Mr. Arroyo found his secret weapon, his lucky turkey hat. And from then on out, there was no looking back. He had one goal in mind: set the world record for most gobbles in a 20-minute span. And here we are live with Mr. Arroyo as he is trying to set the world record. We'll check back in throughout the broadcast to see what his count is and how close he is to setting the world record.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Judd. I'm thankful for family, friends, good times, and laughter. I'm also thankful that I get to get up every morning, see a beautiful sunrise, and take on what the day has for me.
Hi, I'm Miss Gora, and I'm thankful for my students and being healthy.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Bratz. I am thankful for family. I'm thankful for my parents because they have always supported me and continue to support me. And I'm truly thankful for my two children and my three grandchildren.
Hi, I'm Miss Harding. I'm so thankful that we're all here in school learning in person. And I'm thankful that all my family is healthy and that I'm on the gold team this year with the awesome teachers. Woohoo!
Hi guys, I'm Mr. Gratchik, 7th grade science teacher. I'm thankful for my parents. They worked really hard to put me through school and put me in an opportunity to succeed. I'm thankful for my wife and my kids, and I'm thankful to have a job here at Elkhorn Area Middle School and work with awesome kids. And I'm also thankful for Fridays. You guys know how much I love Fridays. And Choco Tacos. Have a great Thanksgiving.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Buckeye, and I am thankful for my job, my family, and my kids.
I'm thankful for my students, my family, my friends, and Jesus.
I am really thankful for the small things in life. I'm thankful for the air that I breathe. I'm thankful for my nice warm house and food in my kitchen.
Hello, and welcome to television. Oh my God. Okay. Family?
Mm-hmm.
Oh God. I forgot about this. Football? Whoa! Football.
Sweet potato?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, does he know the category?
Oh,
the category is Elkhorn Area Middle School.
Okay.
Cardio day.
Cardio day.
You gotta add mom.
Oh. Oh. Trailblazer.
Trailblazer.
Gaga ball.
Fundraiser.
Make a list.
Make a wish.
Nintendo Switch.
Nintendo Switch.
Hawaii. Another one. Wow.
Mashed potatoes.
Mm-hmm. Marshmallow.
They get sticky in there. Cornbread.
Mm-hmm.
Cranberry.
Pumpkin bars?
Leftovers!
That's it. For the kids. Again?
Elbow.
Is it a food? Is it a food? Is it a food? Wishbone!
And here we are back in the gym, and he is still going. He is still going strong, giving it his best turkey gobbles.
Hello, I'm Mr. Hammond. I'm very thankful for my family at home. I'm thankful for everybody's health in this time of COVID. I'm thankful for the staff that I work with. Love being here.
Hi, I'm Miss Erickson. I'm thankful for my friends and my family who supported me through everything, whether it was good or bad. They helped me through everything.
I'm Mrs. Nelson. I'm an eighth grade teacher. And some things I'm thankful for. I'm thankful for all of my awesome coworkers who are always more than willing to help me out anytime I need it. I'm thankful for my awesome students who are not gonna vote for me to get pied in the face next week at the Wish Assembly. And something I'm very thankful for is my stomach is now big enough that when I get home from work, I can sit on my couch and my bowl of ice cream rests just perfectly right on my stomach. It is awesome. And that's what I'm thankful for.
Hi. I'm Mrs. Mariano, the school psychologist at Elkhorn Area Middle School, and what I'm thankful for is being able to come to school every day and work with the students and teachers, and also for my family.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Landier. I am so thankful to be working at Elkhorn Area Middle School and for all the wonderful students that I get to work for. I work with. I'm also thankful for my healthy family and grateful for everyone staying healthy so we can continue to be face-to-face.
Hi, I'm Carrie Keisley. I teach 7th grade social studies for the Patriots team. I'm very grateful that I have so many friends and family and wonderful colleagues and students who are amazing listeners. I'm extremely grateful for all of that.
I'm Sharon Kuczynski and I teach art at Elkhorn Area Middle School. And I'm thankful for seeing my class every day and watching what they create, and I'm also thankful that my family has stayed healthy.
Hi, I'm Ms. Harmeyer. This year I feel like I have a lot of things to be thankful for. I'm incredibly grateful for my family, my friends, their overall well-being and health, my crazy dog Jack, and just being able to see you all and teach in person.
Hello everybody, and welcome to Cooking with Mr. Sorensen. Today, I'm going to show you guys how to cook a spicy four cheese mashed potato dish. It'll be a hit for the holidays no matter where you go. To begin my masterpiece, I go to my local small town grocery store. Once I arrive, I seek out the best possible ingredients for my food. They can be hard to find, but I always look for the freshest Idahoan potatoes available. Then off to start my cheese blend. When I can, I like to buy my ingredients organic. I always like to add a little crunch. And then to top it off with a little bit of spice. Once back to the kitchen, I bring a special blend of hydrogen and oxygen to a boil on the stovetop. I then prep the potatoes. Something unique to this dish is I like to mash the potatoes before they go into the pot. I then start making my four cheese blend. Notice the crunching motion and the rolling of the fist. You really want to roll the fist to get the crunch. Then, with a very sharp knife, you want to begin to chop up your spicy cheese into very small parts. Now that our custom blend of hydrogen and oxygen is boiling, it is time to add the potatoes. Once the potatoes are added, I stir them in very carefully. I then begin to add my cheese. I try to be conservative when adding some of the cheese. Time to add a little crunch. And then again, stir all of our ingredients together. Lastly, we want to add the spiciness to our dish. Notice how I add the pieces to the top. It really adds some flair to the overall look of the dish.
It's time to enjoy our dish.
We have breaking news. Mr. Arroyo has done it. He has said gobble over 700,000 times in the last 10 minutes. He is now officially the world record holder for most gobbles in 10 minutes.
Hi, I'm Mr. McBurney. I'm thankful for great students, great staff, and that we all get to have a little bit of time off here to reset and come back charged for December and continue on a good year.
Hi, this is Ms. Rimey, and I am thankful for our staff that continues to be creative and work hard, our students who show up every day ready to learn, and my family who I love very much.
Heidi Alvarez, I am so thankful for Ms. Kathy Gordon.
Kathy Gordon, I'm so thankful for Ms. Taylor.
Ms. Taylor, very thankful for Ms. Alvarez.
And we're all thankful for Mrs. Stone.
Yep.
And we're thankful for this amazing team we get to work with.
We have a great team.
Hi, I'm Ms. C. I am very thankful for all of you here at Elkhorn Area Middle School. I know I'm nice and cheesy. Have a good break.
Hi, my name is Mr. Robers, and I am grateful for my family, being able to spend a lot of time with them lately, and I'm also grateful for having great students and great staff members to work with every day.
Hi, I'm Ms. Frankenberg, and I am thankful for so many things, but most of all, I'm thankful that I am still blessed to have both my parents at 90 and 86 years old.
Hi, I'm Senior Jamoki, and I am thankful for my friends, my family, our health, and having the means to be able to give back in Wish Week.
So, welcome to Turkey Day, True or False. I am going to read you guys questions, and then you are going to respond with either true or false. First question. Eating turkey makes you sleepy. True or false? Whoop. I'm back.
No, don't hold it up yet.
3, 2, 1. And the correct answer is true. Turkey contains an amino acid, tryptophan, which is a natural sedative.
Ah, please, it doesn't work with me.
Do we need to keep track of our own points?
Nope, I am doing that as well. Question number two. In the 1700s, Ben Franklin wanted the turkey to be the national bird of the United States instead of the bald eagle. True or false? 3, 2, 1.
I'm not ready.
Answers? It is true. Benjamin Franklin in 1784 suggested the wild turkey would be a more appropriate national bird.
Ms. Rimey's the only one who got it wrong.
Gotcha.
Ms. Rimey, who was a former
social studies.
Yeah. Yep. You know.
Okay. Question number three. True or false? The word turkey has 7 letters in it. Show your answers in 3, 2, 1. Correct.
What type of questions are these?
Like, in fact, the word turkey only has 6 letters in it. Okay, next question. True or false? The NFL played its first football game on Thanksgiving Day in 1920. True or false? 3, 2, 1. The answer is true. The
The NFL's tradition of playing football has been around for a long time, starting in 1920. True or false? Wild turkeys hibernate in the month of November because they are afraid of becoming food for Thanksgiving. 3, 2, 1. False. Turkeys don't hibernate or know what Thanksgiving is.
This one almost put true.
I didn't know that.
Okay.
I just guessed.
Professional eater Joey Chestnut once ate over 6 pounds of turkey in 1 hour. True or false? 3, 2, 1. The answer is false. He actually ate 9 pounds of turkey in under 10 minutes.
But then it's kind of true because he did eat the 6 pounds of turkey.
Facts.
Oh. Okay, well, since everybody got it wrong, doesn't matter. Good point.
Joey Chestnut is actually the world record holder, I'm pretty sure, for hot dog eating competitions.
He's an idol, actually, of mine.
Yeah.
You don't tune in every 4th of July?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Next question. Abe Lincoln was the president who declared Thanksgiving a national holiday. Three, two, one. The answer is true. Honest Abe declared Thanksgiving a national holiday in 1863.
I want a fact checker from that.
So, the current score is Ambach has 5, Ms. Rogowski has 4, Sunita Tamilki has 4, and Ms. Rimey has 3. Okay. Next question. Gravy was invented in 1913 by a train conductor named Samuel R. Gravy. True or false? 3, 2, 1. The answer is false.
Oh, she's on the board.
Historians believe gravy was invented around the time of the Revolutionary War.
Well, I'm still
cute. Slimy's making a push.
That was such a specific fact, I figured it had to be true.
I was like, that has to be fabricated. That's way too...
A train conductor. Okay. True or false? There are 4 cities in the United States named Turkey. 3, 2, 1. It is actually true. There are towns in Arizona, Texas, Louisiana, and North Carolina that are named Turkey.
I bet they're very popular destinations on Thanksgiving.
Okay. Last question of the first round.
Wait, this is the like first round?
No, sorry, I said that weird. Last question of the regular round before the bonus question. True or false? Turkeys are terrified of water and will drown almost immediately if they ever fall into a lake due to their bulky feathers. Three, two, one. The answer is false. Turkeys are surprisingly good at swimming. So.
When's the last time anyone saw a turkey in a pond?
I had one in my pond.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
In your backyard?
So.
You know, your pond is like 2 inches.
Small turkey.
Oh, please. Girls, put the claws away. Put the claws away. I'm not joking here.
Okay, so at the end of the regular round, Manager Ambach has 5, Ms. Rogowski has 4, Senorita Milky has 5, and Ms. Rimey has 4. So, before we answer our bonus question, on your paper, write how many points you want to wager from 0 to either 4 or 5, however many you have, how many points you want to wager for the final question. Don't show me.
And why would that make a difference?
Because they would know how much they need to wager then.
No, I'm not talking about showing you. I'm talking about like how many points we give.
Because if you get the question right, you get that many points. And if you get it wrong, you lose that many points. So if you wager 1 and you get it wrong, you lose a point. Or you could wager 0, right? Like not wager any of your points.
Or you could wager 5. And then if you got it right, you would win. Okay. Are we ready?
Yeah.
For the bonus round. Oh, she's telling us.
Yeah, did you not have 5?
You have 4 points, Jess.
He has 4.
Can I be negative?
No.
Let's get 100 points. Okay, here we go. For the bonus points, true or false, the day after Thanksgiving is the busiest day of the year for plumbers.
For what?
Plumbers.
Plumbers. People who fix toilets.
Yes, thank you. Oops.
As well as other things like drains.
And pipes.
And pipes, correct.
And hoses, like when your cat bites through the hose and there's water filling up your basement.
Right. Okay. The day after Thanksgiving is the busiest day for plumbers. True or false? 3, 2, 1. The answer is true.
Woo!
According to Roto-Rooter. Roto-Rooter, which is one of the largest plumbing companies in North America. Plumbers get more calls the day after Thanksgiving than any other day of the year. So, with that being said, Ms. Rogowski wagered 4, so she has 8. Senorita wagered 5, so she's up to 10. Manager Ambach, how many did you wager?
2.
That brings you up to 7, and Ms. Rimey was incorrect. So that leaves Senorita Milky as the champion of Turkey Day, true or false.
Thanks for the applause.
Good job, everybody.
Okay, I have a good way to continue this.
Does anyone know the inner temperature that the turkey needs to be before you can eat it?
165.
Poultry.
165.
Okay, thanks for interrupting me.